Hey, this is Vance Joy, and you're watching Stingray Pause Play.
I am Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Stingray Pause Play here for round two with Vance Joy. Hi, man.
Hey, how you going?
Very good to see you. It's been 3 years since we last hung out on that bed.
Yeah, that was nice and intimate. Yeah, it's good to be back.
Yeah, very good. So, since the last time that we spoke, because Riptide had just come out almost when we had spoke, so that now is the official longest charting song in Australian history, beating out Lady Gaga's Poker Face.
Yeah.
It has the longest chart. I mean, how does that feel to know that your song was loved for so long that it beat out such a huge track?
It feels great. You never know what to expect when you write a song and then you record it. You have no idea where it's going to go. And so it had this, amazing longevity, which I think is what opened the door for me to have a career. So I'm very, very happy with that.
So going back a little bit further than 3 years, what's your fondest musical childhood memory?
I have a memory of running around in, it would have been our living room, and there was a singer called Paul Kelly from Australia, and he had a song called called Dumb Things. And I just remember it was on like a compilation CD. I think Mustang Sally was on there, a few other songs, and I just remember like singing and dancing, and I used to dance and twist and spin around as a little kid, and it was the energy in that, and that's what I think of.
Is that still how you dance?
I think in the right circumstances, with the right, if everything falls into place, that might be seen, but I'm pretty subdued.
It's a rare occasion. Okay. Yeah. Do you remember the first time that you wrote a song and the reason why you felt you wanted to put words to music?
Yeah, I remember when I got my braces, I was 14 and I was playing a Crowded House song and I knew the chords to the song, but I changed the lyrics to about getting my braces, and it was kind of like a way of expressing, I don't know, making a joke out of it or something. They didn't look great, and it was a kind of like, you're in the awkward age of being kind of in puberty and you got braces and like everything's kind of like against you. But I wrote this song and I sung my own lyrics to that song, and I remember doing that and really liking that.
Do you remember how that goes?
The first thing was, honestly, I don't remember the rest of it. It was kind of it was emotional, but a joke emotional song. And it was just, the first line was, "Today I got my braces on." I can't remember the rest of it, but...
sounds like a good start.
You get the idea of the song with the first line.
Obviously, you've almost been on tour nonstop since we last met. You don't get home very often. When you do get home, what are the must-haves and the things you have to do when you get there? Is there a place you have to eat? Is there a person you have to see?
Yeah, I think, my family, so my mum and dad and my little sister. Recently, my sister and I have been kind of going, I bought her a skateboard, so we've both got skateboards, so we kind of go for a little roll around, and just like the local coffee shops. There's a few good cafes in the local area. It's very suburban, but there's a couple of decent places that have opened up recently, so... just a good breakfast, coffee.
And are you a longboarder, or are you like a skateboard, do tricks off stuff, kind of jump around person?
Well, very, very, very mediocre trick skater. But I love it. I love even just doing the smallest thing. I get totally stoked if I like can kickflip. I'm like,
I can't even ride a longboard. I'm that guy.
I'm
useless. I fall right off. It's terrible. So we asked the last artist to ask you a question.
Yes.
The artist is Run the Jewels.
Yeah.
And the question is.
Yeah.
Hey, what up? We are Run the Jewels, and
our question is,
sativa or indica?
I think that for me it would be the one that doesn't make you go trippy. Do you know which one that is?
I always forget.
I think I'm an indica guy. I think I'm an indica, yeah.
Might be sativa.
That's like a good, like, badass question.
Let's chat Lay It On Me. The song feels like a real happening. It doesn't feel like a fictional event that you kind of made up. So tell me a bit about what's going on in the song. I know you say, you're talking about kind of the note in the jacket pocket, and it feels like in class when you'd say, will you go out with me? Yes, no, maybe, circle one. So tell me a bit about that song, where it comes from.
Yeah, that image, that kind of came, the idea of the note. I've done that before. I think it's like a really sweet way of you get a little surprise when you get a note or a little message. So there's something really romantic about that I can relate to. And then I also saw it, there's a film called, it's with Adam Driver, Patterson. He's a bus driver. There's like a poet, and his wife leaves him like little notes and little like pictures and stuff in his lunchbox, and I was like, I love that. It's such a romantic thing. So I think I kind of used that and put that into my song. And yeah, for me, the song is just about being in relationship and letting your defenses down and kind of being vulnerable. And yeah, I'm stoked to have a new song to play.
Yeah, I bet. The music video also just came out recently, and it's great. It's got kind of that super retro vibe. Tell me about how the music video connects to the song.
Yeah, I love that you asked about the film clip, because I'm really happy with it. I got to work with this director, Mimi Cave. She's done a bunch of great film clips. She did some for Sylvanesso and Tune Yards, and I got to work with this actress, Angela Serafian, who
from
is
Westworld,
from Westworld,
right?
Yeah.
Amazing.
So I was like, oh my God, how lucky am I? I got to spend 2 days doing this film clip. And I guess for me, Mimi's idea was, you know, there's like, you know, little moments of a relationship, and you see that it's almost like I feel like it's almost like she's kind of toying with me a bit, and she's kind of out of reach, and then like we're kind of, I don't know, like not touching, you know, it's kind of like this kind of weird this energy of like intimacy, but then also distance. So
absolutely.
So I love that. That was all her, and all those beautiful sequences are her and the dance coordinators and the whole team. But I just love the retro vibe. I like, you know, Brian Ferry film clips.
Absolutely.
So I kind of, that was a couple of the ideas. I was like, these are my inspirations. And then she totally interwove them. So yeah. I was stoked.
It's great. I love it. I've watched it maybe 10 times. Probably shouldn't
legendary.
Admit that to you, but it's really, really great.
That makes me happy.
It's fun to watch. When can we expect another album? When can we expect another full-length Vance Joy record?
I'm working away on it. I've got a few songs that I'm really happy with. So we're playing three new songs in the set, and you know, hopefully soon, I'll probably push it to the last kind of realistic moment, and then I'll have an album.
And what can we expect to be a little bit different on the second album from the first album? Were there things you didn't like on the first album that maybe you changed? Or
I think mostly things I like, you know, but there's always little things you're like, oh, I would do that differently. But ultimately, I think, you know, just over time you might change a little, and the way you play your instrument and your voice changes because you've done a bunch of gigs. So I think you find different ways of you know, writing songs. So there's I think hopefully a progression and an evolution in my songwriting, but still the same flavors, intimate vocals and pretty stripped down kind of instrumentation. So
if I were to burn your house down, what would be the three things that you would grab on the way out?
And it's just the house is empty of people.
We're going to assume there are no living creatures inside.
Nothing alive. I don't know. I mean, I'd probably just go for the photo albums. I think we've got some old photo albums, and I was thinking it's strange that we don't have those anymore, but that was such a thing I used to do as a little kid, like open up the photo albums.
Absolutely.
And like look through these old photos. So I think for mum and dad's sake, I'd try and save, you know, all of those kind of things.
I think that's a beautiful answer, man. Thank you so much for talking with me, man.
My
I
pleasure.
Really appreciate it. So good to see you again. You've just kind of, I'm just glad that there wasn't a peak at Riptide. You know, you're not a one-hit wonder. The
Thank
album
you.
Is sounding great, so I'm really excited for the new music to come out, man.
Thank
really.
You so much.
You can hear Vance Joy on Stingray Music's Hit List channel, Adult Alternative channel, Rock Alternative channel, Alt Rock Classics, Euro Hits, Summer Hits, and of course, all over Stingray Music's Vibes channels, available now on our mobile app and web player. Don't forget to leave us a comment and, of course, subscribe to keep up to date with all the newest Pause Play episodes. See you next time.